Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum. Straight talk about you and your money. Now from the BizTalk studios, here is Gary Kaltbaum.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. I'm Gary Kaltbaum, your host. Hey, thanks for being with us today. Glad you're here, ladies and gentlemen. Happy that you are listening. It's February 26, 2024. And you know what I just realized? Like in a week or so, we get to do that where it's lighter out there. At the end of the day, daylight savings time. I still don't understand why we even change. I love when it's lighter for longer. Seriously. I don't know why we do that. Anyway, hey, this is a show about everything that affects you. The markets, the economy, your money, jobs, unemployment, taxes, deficit spending, scams, shams, corruption, you name it. We cover it. We'll cover a bunch of things today. And if you do not get this radio show in your city, we'll post it at GaryK.com. We'll also post it on our Twitter feed, which is now X. And of course, if you don't follow us on X, you really should follow us on X. Just go there, put our name in, and all that fun stuff. Hey, and you can email me, just be nice. By the way, the person with the fake email address that kept saying I'm lying about buying NVIDIA at the 505 on the breakout, I challenged him, what I say, 25 to 1 or 20 to 1 on his 10 grand. Isn't that what I put? I think that's what I did. And of course, nothing came. I love people. You know, I always taught my kids, always think the best of people. Let them prove you wrong the other way. Such is life. All right. First off, the indices didn't do a lot today, but I do want to cover a few things. Part markets, part me whining and complaining, and all that fun stuff. So let me start by saying, do you remember when I always tell you about 1999, how mutual funds changed their name to the so-and-so technology fund, to the so-and-so internet fund, so they would attract more money? And then when the internet went bust, well, we had the bear market, they changed it back. Or companies would just announce websites and the stock would soar, or they would add .com to their names. Well, we got this AI thing going on right now, and all of a sudden, this is McDonald's makes an announcement. Oh, they're going to do AI through the drive-thrus. Why would they need to make that announcement? Interesting. Just letting you know. Saw a couple of others today, and you just got to be careful about all that. Please, be careful. We think AI is going to go higher, but there's going to be, listen carefully, more than likely some sort of bubble coming up, which means great money to make going forward. But be ready when it pops. That's how it always works, where everybody jumps on each other and jumps, and will buy anything at any price if it has AI to it. And eventually, it'll hit the wall. I think I said Friday, I got calls from people I don't even know asking me about NVIDIA. I tried to ask back, do you know what the stock's done in the last year? So we'll let you know names. You get to decide. It's your money. Game's still on. Didn't end. But I want to make note of a few things that came by my desk today that may or may not be important. You know, there's certain people we follow in markets. One of them, Jamie Dimon from J.P. Morgan. Now, he doesn't have a great record on predicting markets. I believe it was October last year when he said market's going 20% lower and the market bottom. I can go on. But I just want to let you know he sold 821,000 shares of his JP Morgan stock worth $150 million for the first time ever. Now, maybe he's just getting older. I don't know. But I did want to report that to you. Maybe it's nothing. And by the way, he bought 1.2 million shares in the open market from 2009 to 2016. Maybe, maybe not. Electric vehicles. We warned you a long time ago. Our thought process was simple. Number one, I didn't think people would really adopt it. I think people would buy, and there's been a lot of Teslas bought and others. But when all said and done, I just didn't think, and we've been telling you so and telling you so, and we warned you also about the stocks, that especially with the SPACs, a bunch of crooks came out and said they were going to merge with electric vehicle companies. They were liars, and I think only one or two going to jail. But let me just read a few things to you, if you don't mind. Number one, Faraday Future. You ever hear of that? Hit a high of $1,652 in March 21. I believe it did a reverse split. It's 8 cents. They never sold a car. No, really. Just letting you know. Anybody hear of, let's see if it's still around and I can pick it up. Lordstown Motors. And I think that's the guy who went on a certain channel and lied about contracts. Hit a high of $453. It's $1.35. We want you to remember these. I don't think they've sold any cards. How about something called Canoe? Electric vehicles. Hit a high of $25. That was a SPAC, I believe, at 10. It's a dime. Nikola. You remember that one because I think the guy's in jail for that one. That was a SPAC. Hit a high of 94. It's 72 cents. How about Fisker? Fisker. And by the way, I think they have some sales. That one's gone from 30 down to 60 cents. That was another SPAC. How about Lucid? That's one. That was a SPAC. Hit a high of $65. It's three. How about QuantumScape? Hit a high of $133. It's six. You know what they do? Lithium batteries. They have no sales still. How about anybody hear of Lion Electric? I actually didn't even hear of that one. And they have sales. Hit a high of 35. It's $1.72. Of course, there's the Rivian, which we warned you about. We nailed that here in TV. 180 was the high. It's 10 bucks. By the way, they have pretty good sales. I hear they lose thousands of bucks on every one, and I just think that I think they're firing a bunch of people because they just ain't selling like they used to. How about Green Power Motors? Hit a high. Well, ooh, you can go back farther than that. Was a buck in 2015. Hit 34 in 21. Oh, it's back to $2. How about VinFast? This one's been recent. It just came out and went straight up to 93. It's 5. They're in Vietnam. How about NIO, symbol NIO? They have sales. Hit a high of 67. It's 5. How about XPeng? EXPEV. They have sales too. Hit a high of 75. It's now 9. Do I need to go further? I think I'm good. You know why we're doing this, right? What's the number one rule of investing? The number one rule of investing is protecting your capital. Always be along for another ride. And if you get caught up in stupid without thinking, you know, like the AMC theaters, which, by the way, I'm pretty sure I'm right in saying this. It hit a high of $393 June of 21. It's $4. Last I looked, that's down 90-some-odd percent. And whatever, whatever the reason, when we tell you something's a bubble, we mean it. And we're pretty good at measuring what's a bubble versus not, and it's pretty much based on one simple thing. Would you take a $10 bill and trade it for a dollar? That's what it comes down to, simplicity. Would you trade a $10 bill for a dollar? The answer is negative. And we just want to point these things out, and you pretty much can tell when just stupid's going on. You know what people have lost a lot of money on in the last year? Wait till you hear up next, because I don't think people know about this. And then the markets. This is the one only Investor's Edge.
Hi, I'm Gary Kaltbaum, host of the nationally syndicated radio show Investor's Edge. We're not just handsome radio people. We manage investors' money for a living, specializing in fee-based discretionary money management. No big commissions, just a fee on the assets that's managed. We also provide a full range of personalized services, including retirement planning, fixed income, and educational needs, all to assist you in achieving your financial goals. Understanding not all individuals have the same needs, we'll carefully evaluate your personal goals to determine a proper investment strategy. If your current approach to investing is not getting you to where you would like to be, call us to make an appointment for a complimentary portfolio review. The number to call is 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. Investment advisory services offered through Kaltbaum Capital Management.
It's time to switch on the integrator units and get the brain cells working.
You're listening to...
Hey, this promises to be fun.
Investor's Edge.
The last bastion of quality programming.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
It doesn't get better than this.
So I don't know if you know this. You know what a big thing has been? Luxury watches and stuff. Have you been reading about it? I mean, from what I'm told, you can't even get a Rolex. I mean, it's like you got to wait like forever. But there's all these other watches, and supposedly, not supposedly, they've just dropped like 30-40% in price. Used Teslas have crashed in price. I used to crash when 30-40%. So we're starting to see that, and let me just say also, high-end real estate, not everywhere, it's location, but there's a lot of things blowing up in real estate on the high end. And when I say blowing up, I'm seeing some 30 and 40% markdowns on some high-end stuff. Now, I don't know if that's going to turn into everything, but we're starting to see a little bit of that, and just letting you know, I think it's important. What else on I got to report to you? Well, I don't know if you know this. The Dow, the people at the Dow put Walgreens in the Dow 30 in 2018 around $65. It's now 21. They took out, they put in Walgreens, they took out General Electric. That's gone from 80 to 154 bucks. The problem with some of these people is they want to go with the hot versus not, and now they took Walgreens out. And what did they put in? Amazon. Rightfully so. But I own a little Amazon, and I'm all of a sudden scared. Because Dow's got a little bit of a reputation. We'll see. But I just wanted to report that to you. I thought that of import. What else do I got for you? And just of note. So, please listen carefully. The hottest area in the market is technology, obviously, and the sub-part of that is the artificial intelligence. And the semiconductors and software companies in artificial intelligence, stocks have had some good moves. You know the names. We've been telling you about them. But did you know? Listen carefully. The biggest losers will be coming from this area. Not now. I'm just letting you know, be ready. Harken back to 21 when we thought all the growth stocks were topping. We told you something we learned from William O'Neill. Bear markets will take down previous leaders on average 70%. And we know this is fact because we have gone backwards, but also from 2021 during the 70% plus, some worse than others, and many of them have not come back. Others to a certain extent. There are some stocks up 100% in the last year off the lows and are still down 50 to 60% from the highs of 21. So we want to let you know that. And it will be imperative, and this will be a little bit of a patting on the back, it'll be imperative for you to listen to this show. And let me explain the psychology of why. While we'll be paying attention to the market and price and patterns, when things top out, Wall Street's going to be telling you, don't worry, it's a normal correction after a strong move. Now remember 21, because that's what they did as always. And the first 10% drop is not a big deal. And Wall Street was telling you, don't worry, it's just a correction. And then it was down 25%. Well, we've seen this before. And then 50%, oh crap. And some charlatans would tell you they told you so. It's just like right now, let me tell you what I'm watching. I'm seeing people telling us, yeah, we own NVIDIA. They bought it like last week after it was already up a bazillion percent, just so they can say they own NVIDIA. We'll be paying attention to price, not opinion. And we can tell you now up front, when the storm hits, there's going to be a lot of destruction, and the higher it goes, and if it does turn into a bubble, and arguably there's some things now, you better be ready. And while everybody will be telling you, don't worry, everything's okay, the smart money will be out not saying a word because they don't want to let you know they sold. And the big mouse will be saying, don't worry, everything's okay. While we'll be telling you, oh, that sucker's topped. We don't know when that occurs. We don't know from where it occurs. We don't know which one starts it off. We don't know why it starts off. We just know it's going to happen. So we're giving you upfront. And we say that because technology stocks are outperforming the rest of the S&P 500 by the largest margin in history. Much more than the year 2000, 1999, and before that. That means they are overowned, overloved, overleveraged, and eventually overhyped and overpriced. We're not there yet. And I can tell you today was another one of those days where they mostly outperform. Next. For all the talk of inflation, let me give you the real story. In the last year, cotton's up 14%, gold's up 12%, silver's up 8%, sugar's up 7%. Crude is only up 1%. Brent crude down 2%. Heating oil down 2%. Gasoline down 3%. Copper down 4%. Coffee down 5%. Aluminum down 9%. Zinc down 21%. Wheat down 24%. Soybeans 25%. Natural gas 30%. Corn 37%. So just letting you know. Now, of course, I don't have on this list cocoa, which has skyrocketed. over the last few months, for whatever reason, beats the hell out of me why, but just letting you know. And of course, we will watch oil prices because that has a lot to do with it. And just so you know, they have this Bloomberg Commodities Index. It's fallen to the lowest since 2021. So there's a little info. And last, we finish off. Remember Palo Alto Networks? The stock got just creamed recently. Down like $100 on earnings. It was up 30 today, finished up 21. Let me tell you why. The greatest insider trader of all time, Nancy Pelosi, it was announced she bought options in it, and the market went up just on that. What? Nancy Pelosi? What? Just so you know, they have to disclose. Now, just so you know what Nancy Pelosi and these others in D.C. do, they do insider trading, illegal insider trading for us, legal for them. We'll explain up next. And then today's action. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
You're listening to
America is Talking
Investor's Edge.
He's got to be pleased with that. The crowd is just on its feet here. Cinderella boy.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
Comes highly recommended. You're going to feel better if you talk to him.
So, just so you know, you and I are not allowed to trade on what is known as material information. In other words, just so you know, there's a story out today where a couple got divorced because the wife was working at home. And the husband heard her talk about, was it a merger or some contract or something? And he traded on it. He's going to jail. She's not in trouble because he basically, and she didn't know, supposedly, she was fired from her job. He's going to jail. So let's say I found out from some, I'm in Orlando, Central Florida. Who's housed here? Oh, Disney. So imagine if I knew somebody at Disney and they called me up to let me know, hey, I just want to let you know that Disney is buying Apple. I heard it. Go buy some Apple. Actually, nobody's buying Apple. Disney's buying Paramount. And then I go and buy Paramount stock. I'm going to jail. That is material information. Got that? It's very simple. But in Washington, D.C., they're trading on all their inside information. They're scum. Every one of them that trades like that are scum. It's like third world country scum. That they would actually, and they do it in plain sight, to the point where there's some people trying to put through legislation that they can't trade stocks anymore, nothing gets done. But the greatest scum insider trade has been Nancy Pelosi because she's made bazillions. And she, her timeliness has been off the charts good. The stock Palo Alto Networks actually moved just on that today. That's how sick it is. By the way, I'd say it to her face. Remember, when we rip on politicians here and name them, not one thing would I not say to their face. They'll get me arrested, but I would say it to their face. So I just want to let you know Palo Alto moved on that. Was up 30, finished up 20. Whatever. And that's a little bit about today. Now, the market wrap. We'll have it brought to you by investment-models.com today. That's Jim Rohrbach, one of the great market timers. No gray areas with the man. You're either in or out of the market with his proprietary indicators. Go check it out. Investment-models.com. The Dow was down 62. The S&P was down 20. NASDAQ only down 20. NASDAQ 100 only down 4. Weird, huh? But guess what? Broadcom 12, Arm Holdings 12, that is Supermicro 16, ASML Holdings 14, KLA 10 Core 15, Lam Research 10. It was another decent day for some of the AI. Not all, but it was a pretty good day. And the semiconductors are up 48 today. And software strong, though it came in at the end, because a lot of it was Palo Alto Networks early. Mixed bag. The other part of today, crypto. So we told our peeps on Friday and over the weekend, man, I think crypto's setting up for making another move. Why? Because it just had this quality-looking pullback. Remember, photo album, familiar faces. Well, holy crap, Coinbase up $28 today to $193. Up 16%. MicroStrategy up $109. Well, both up 16%. And they just shot him out of a cannon today. Wow. So we're just letting you know the Ethereum and the Bitcoin are definitely in motion here. Whatever the reason, we don't want you to forget that most coins are at zero. But these, there is no doubt in my mind they have staying power. And as we have said to you, whether or not they go to numbers that some of these creeps are telling you, we don't have any idea, but we just use it as a technical basis, and they're strong. Just letting you know. And some of the companies and the miners and things like that have something to do with it are strong. Dang strong. And I still don't understand why. But people are paying up for it, and we'll see where it goes. Just letting you know. Really nice. Otherwise, I didn't even realize this. There's still another hundreds and hundreds of earnings reports this week. But as I went through, well, Domino's Pizza report today, I was up $25. And some things we just don't understand. Earnings were up 1%, revenues were up 1%, and the stock was up 25%. But throughout the rest of the week, there's just not a lot of big-time names reporting, but a lot of names. And what we will do with you guys is anything that sticks out. Well, Salesforce.com is in the Dow. Best Buy reports, Dollar Tree, which is now really a dollar and a quarter tree. Dell reports this week, but that's, you know, we'll let you know if anything sticks out like a sore thumb. But I didn't realize there's a heck of a lot of names reporting again this week. What do I know? But overall market, fine. I will tell you there's some names that don't look fine. As we have stated for the record, Apple remains very weak versus the market. Trading below long-term moving averages. And let me give you a number. If Apple breaks cleanly 180, and it closed at 181 and change, yeah, you're probably going to, well, probably 170 to be seen. Relative strength versus the market continues to tank. Whatever the reason. Have we gotten to the point where just the amount of people now upgrading to the next phone finally hitting some sort of wall? You know, just remember, I think it was iPhone 4 when I said, who wants to get an iPhone 5? So I'm the doofus on that. And I also thought the iPod was just going to be a Walkman. So just letting you know, on the Apple front, really needs to hold the 180. But more importantly, just if you get a chart of the NASDAQ, overlay it with Apple, and you will see that Apple's not doing what it used to do. Now, that said, because we're not stupid, we give you both sides. There's been a couple of times where the NASDAQ has soared and Apple has stunk. And then Apple got going again. In fact, 2013 totally underperformed the whole year. It's up about sevenfold since then. So we'll see. The issue is, though, again, what else can you do with a phone that's going to make people jump to the next phone? And as I've said to you, I'm like an Apple devotee. I haven't upgraded, whatever word is, I haven't gone to the next phone in three phones. Quite unusual for me. And they give you these incentives to do it. Hey, we'll pay you this for your phone, this, that, and the other thing. So just letting you know, keep in mind, it's had a monstrous run. And every now and then, you know, but Apple now is sitting right where it was December of 21. So 22, 23, two years and change. And not bad, 10% off its high, so not the biggest of deals, just versus the market. It's not doing what it used to do, and you know what that is, lead the market. So just a heads up, no, we didn't tell you to sell it. We don't own any right now. And we'd love to. We love big names. We love big names. But not that right now. Tesla's one that's been very weak versus the market. Had a decent day today because one of the China autos, LI Li Motors, came out with some pretty big numbers today. That was up 18%. And by the way, Li Motors, Li Auto, LI, it's one of the stronger electric vehicle names out of China. Yeah, I got to tell you, really big numbers. Sales up 130, earnings up 341. I'm going to have to do some investigation on that tonight. Huh, why them? Up next, we got some whining and complaining. Thanks for being here. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
You're listening to...
What are we waiting for?
Well, what are you waiting for?
One, two, ready, go.
Action! Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum.
Hey, yo. March 20th is a Wednesday. The people at the Money Show... And it's so weird because... I've never really done money shows for the money show people, and they asked me to do one in Las Vegas, the Traders Expo, I think it was called. And I come in there, and there was the room was for 100, and I believe there was 150. And you would think they would ask you a bunch more times, and they never asked me again. And I don't really go out there to, hey, why don't you ask? I just, you know, no big deal. So they finally asked me. But the first one I'm doing is a virtual expo. It's the Money Show Virtual. March 20th. It's just going to be for a half hour, 11:30 a.m. to noon. And what I usually do, where the markets are right now. And that's what we'll be doing. What's leading, what's lagging, what to avoid, all that. And at my Twitter feed, X now, it's a pinned tweet. If you'd like to sign up, just go there and sign up. And you can join me for a half hour of markets, March 20th, a Wednesday. And I'm pretty sure you can sign up and then get it afterwards. So it's a pinned tweet. And what I'll do is I will put the I'll post it on my website also at GaryK.com. I will do that tonight. And I believe, I got to make sure, yeah. They asked me to do Las Vegas Money Show. They actually asked me to do Orlando recently, but I was in New York City for my parents. I got Vegas, and I'll actually be there for that on a weekend because I hate traveling during the week. Got to work. And I'll let you know dates. That's not till the summertime. You know, what we do on this show is business, markets, and DC, and the media. We think so many have let you and I down, and your families down, because they're just lying sacks. And we've watched the media report the way they want to report, black things out they don't want to report, make things up when they want to go after somebody, and on and on and on and on and on. And as you know, the biggest story right now going into the election is immigration. It's the biggest story. The poll numbers say it. And you know it because Biden is also already talking about some, I'm going to do something on the border here, even though he said he couldn't without the Congress or he needed money, which is a lie because that's what they do is they lie. And now he's going to visit the border this week. As we have told you, his poll numbers on immigration are worse than root canal and jock itch. So now they're going to the border. But more importantly, and immigration is so important, some of these cities are spending so much money that could go to the homeless and children on these migrants. And, you know, a lot of these families just want a better life, and that's why they're coming here. But if you don't have a border, you don't have, really don't have a country. And Biden is just a nightmare, and he blames it on the other side. And you know I can't stand the other side either, but it's not their fault. In fact, Trump did a pretty decent job with the border when he was president, and it's a very tough thing to do. And they were ripping him for trying to put up a wall. I can go on and on and on and on and on and on. But what pisses me off most is the media. And let me just tell you what they did. Number one, whenever they talk immigration, they finally had to talk immigration the last 3 or 4 weeks. They never mentioned Joe Biden. Never, because we can't do that. And even though children have died and families have died, can't do that. Even though kids were put in cages, couldn't do that when under Trump that happened, they ripped them 24/7. But what sticks in my craw, an illegal immigrant murdered a young girl who was jogging at the University of Georgia. Murdered. And we know most illegal immigrants are not murderers, are not even not criminals. But still, because of the ridiculous policies, this guy was let in, was arrested a couple of times, let out, nothing done. AP, the Associated Press, I should come up with a better name for them. They're in the tank, just so you know. They suck. They don't care about you. They're for one side. They hate the other side. What do they report on? Their whole article on this girl who died had nothing to do with an illegal immigrant that murdered her. It had to do with, you shouldn't go out jogging by yourself. I'm not making this up. And this is exactly why nobody trusts these people. It's exactly why people like Trump gets the amount of votes they get, because unfortunately, the fix is in so many places, and they don't care. They keep telling you that they are the people that hold power to account. Meet the Press this weekend had Gavin Newsom on, the governor of California. Do you think they asked him about California and what's going on there? The fact that they're running massive deficits even though they have massive taxes, where's the money going? Do you think they asked about that? Do you think they asked about the homeless and the homeless camps? Do you think they asked them? Nope. Do you think they asked them about San Francisco, what's going on there, or even asked Pelosi? They never asked Pelosi about what's going on in San Francisco. So we're just letting you know, we hate them all. Hate's a big word. We dislike them all. We can't stand the Republicans. We can't stand the Democrats. We think they're all hacks. There's maybe a couple of good people left in D.C., but the rest are in the tank. Just letting you know, please do your own homework. Please be careful about who you read. No, there is no Loch Ness Monster. No, 9/11 wasn't an inside job. Believe me, I get people who email me that. Think smart. Know who's and who isn't. And we're not looking for perfection. You know what we're looking for? What journalists are supposed to do. Hold power to account. And it ain't happening. So, and what does that have to do with you and your money? Everything. It's all about the future. That all said, you have a great evening. Drive carefully. When you get home, do like we do. Quite simple. Make sure you hug your family. Make sure you hug your children. They will feel better. You will feel better. I promise. Have a great evening, everybody. Same time tomorrow. I'm taking a nap. Good night. Bye-bye.
This has been Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum on BizTalk. To listen to past episodes or to get in contact with Gary, go to GaryK.com. That's GaryK.com.